Hi everyone, welcome to Eckhart Yoga. I'm Esther and I'm here with the lovely Masha. And today's class, we're going to find peace and in a way seclusion, if you like, through focusing on the breath during the yin yoga poses. So once you really get focused on the breath and you forget about everything else, it's like a meditation. And once you meditate and there's just that focus, everything else falls away and your body reorganizes itself so it becomes peaceful and calm. So that's what we're going to attempt. During that process, you will notice your mind might be getting a little wild, and that's part of it. So don't think you're doing it wrong when that happens. Actually, you're working through something. So it's all okay. All you need to do is keep coming back to your breath when you notice yourself moving away from it and go, ah, now I'm awake again, and come back. And that's the moment of celebration, when you notice you've been distracted and you come back to it. So there's no wrong in this practice. There's just sort of training yourself to come back to the breath, just like you're surfing and you're trying to catch a wave. Every wave is one and you fall off and it's messy, but at some point you've got it and you go. And that's a little bit with the breath. And you can just take one breath all the way from the beginning to the top of the in-breath, to the bottom of the in-breath. That's one cycle. And even if you have one breath, that's wonderful. And then the second one, and it's one breath at a time. And we're going to start with ocean sound breathing or ocean breath. And we do that because this breath in itself is very calming. So I'm going to explain it. We have a few cycles of ocean breathing and then we move into the yin poses. So the ocean breath, it's called ocean breath, so we can think of the sound of the ocean. I personally prefer actually the sound of the wind through the trees because it's more subtle. And I think this breath can be a little bit more subtle than a sort of an ocean is a pretty loud sound. So I like the sound of the trees to take that. But okay, so what you just imagine is, you know, when you want to fog up your sunglasses to clean them, it's a little bit what we're doing with the mouth open to start it. So you just go, and then you also do the same on the in-breath. This is not so comfortable. We won't stay like that, but it's just to get used to the sound. And then you make it more subtle. And once you're used to the sound, do the same with your mouth closed. So the air passes a little through the back of the throat, which is slightly contracted. And that's your ocean breath. So it can be very subtle, but there's definitely a sound for you, like the wind of the trees, through the trees, to focus on. And that's the idea with this. So just let's just close our eyes and be with this breathing for a minute or so. And relax yourself, relax your mind, let go of maybe the question, am I doing it right? And just focus on the sound and on the movement in the body. So forget about your insecurities. Just be there with the breath. You really can't do it wrong. And your breathing will settle during the class as well. So relax around this breath. Wonderful. Stay with that breath and we gently move to all fours. And you can face me. And on all fours, still with the ocean breath, we're just going to do some cat-cow movement. So we gently warm up the body a little bit before the yin. So inhaling, lift your head, lift your tail, open your chest, belly sinks down, exhaling round the spine. Head down, tail in, sideways lifts. Two more. You can gently push your hands away as you exhale. So you press your hands towards the front of the mat and then you pull them in during the inhale towards yourself. Come back to neutral. On an in-breath, just lift your right knee up. Keep your knee bent. And then turn it out to the side and bring it back down along the side. And circle two more times that way. And we just bring a little bit of movement and mobility into the hip joint before we start. That's enough. And then we circle the other way. Move forward towards yourself. Out and back. That's perfect. Two more. Keep the breathing just going. And then we place the right knee down and we do the same with the left. So first lift it up behind, to the side and down. Two more. Keep a gentle ujjayi ocean breath going. After you've done three, one side, you go the other way. You draw your knee in towards yourself, out and up behind. Okay. And then move your knees a little further apart and just shift your hips from side to side. Or you place your knees exactly where you feel they're helpful. If it's a bit closer, that's okay too. All right. And then we come for a butterfly pose. We come to sit in a butterfly pose. So you sit on your buttocks. And most of you, it's really nice to have a blanket underneath the buttocks. So you can look at Masha. Wonderful. And then the soles of the feet come together. And for some people, it's nicer to have the feet a little closer. For other people, it's nicer to have the feet a little further apart. So you can choose and make sure it feels right to your body. And just sit straight up. See if you can tilt your hips a little forward so that the spine comes in. Inhale, finding length. And exhale, you can fold forward into your posture. And it's not about how far down you get. It's more about where your body is at. It's your shape. It's your body. You work with the reality of your body. And remember, the focus is the breath. If for whatever reason it feels painful, you can always place support underneath your knees. And if your head is close to the ground and you would like to rest it, you can place it on a block or on your fists. The main focus here is to stay and be present to the breath. And we stay for about 3 minutes. So there's still a soft sound of the wind through the trees. It's not very loud, but there's that focus. And it helps to really calm the mind and center you. Follow the breath all the way from the beginning to the top of the in-breath. Feel that shift moving to the out-breath, all the way to the bottom of the out-breath, a moment of stillness, and the in-breath starts again. One breath at a time you follow. Don't feel you have to be present for 3 minutes, just one breath at a time. One breath and then another breath and then another breath. You may feel how the breath expands your ribcage to the front, back, and the sides. And maybe sometimes all the way to the collarbones. Your lower belly is supporting that breath, so it's not engaged a lot, but it's helping to bring the breath into the ribcage. Forget about everything else, just one breath at a time. On your next inhalation, you can gently come up Help yourself up. And then moving your knees towards each other. Place your hands behind you. Just let your knees rest against each other. Yeah, just take a moment here. Feel what's happened in your hips, in your outer legs. And just for once, you can just move your knees from right. Let your hips come along with them and move them to the left. And then we move on with the next one. Or just another few times just to loosen out what you've done. It's always good to not build up tension in the body. So these in-between gentle movements can be very helpful. Okay, back to center. And then we come into a wide-legged child with a twist. So you can come and sit on your knees. You bring your knees out wide. And you can use the blanket in whatever way you need to, or any other props for that matter. And the shape Masha can show you, you can bring your arms out and then the right arm can tread underneath the left. And you come and land on the outside of your right shoulder. And you might even move your body and shift it over further to the left, but you don't have to. So that depends on if that feels good. And then you can leave your top arm where it is. You can extend it over your head. Or if you wish, you can bring it up to the ceiling, turn your palm out and place it on your lower back or even reaching for your right inner thigh. So you choose at home. Make sure your right shoulder feels safe. And if the floor is too far away, you may place a blanket underneath the upper body so that you bring the floor a little bit higher. And here too we stay for 3 minutes. So be good for your shoulder. For example, I've got a tiny little bit of an injury in my right shoulder, so I'm going to keep some weight in my left arm rather than bringing all the weight onto the right shoulder, and that feels better for me. So you really adapt to the reality of your body. And then you come back to the breath. Remember that sound of the wind, gentle wind through the trees. So that you have something to focus your mind on, so it becomes calm and concentrated. The breath is always now. So when you focus on your breath, you focus on the moment, at least part of you. Even if there's stuff going on in the background, at least part of you is present. And this in itself is hugely beneficial for the health of your mind, the health of your you in daily life. So indeed, it's that simple. You don't have to do anything else. Just being with the in-breath and being present to the out-breath. And then the next breath, in and out. Following it all the way from the beginning to the top of the in-breath. Feel how it shifts into the out-breath. It's almost circular. There's a slight pause before the in-breath starts again. One at a time. With that gentle sound of the wind through the trees. And let go. Your jaw behind your eyes. Your heart relaxes. Gently, you can place your hand back next to your head. So you lift your left arm up, place your palm down where you feel it supporting you, and then you can press yourself up to the middle. Great. Just sit up straight for a moment and feel. You can even bring the knees together. And then we move into the other side. Just the counter pose of this is obviously the other side. So you bring the knees apart again, you come forward. And this time you tread your left leg underneath the right and you place the outside of your left shoulder down. You can keep your arm over your head extended or you can bring it up and place the back of your hand on your lower back or on the inside of your left thigh. Make sure your left shoulder feels safe. Place support wherever you need it. It might even be between your heels and your buttocks. And then we stay again for 3 minutes. Once more, relax your jaw. Relax behind your eyes, deep within the brain. And relax your heart. And a soft sound of the wind through the trees. And every time you notice you've been distracted, it's okay. It's what the mind is used to. All you need to do is the moment you notice it, you're back. You can celebrate that moment. And then again, one breath at a time. Remember, it's like catching that wave. And once you've got it, that's it. And then you fall off again and you catch another one. And that gentle, soft sound, let that help you to focus, to be completely drawn in. So that's seclusion of just the breath, just the sound and the feeling of the breath. And one-pointedness, seclusion brings so much peace. You can gently remove your top arm and bring the palm back on the floor, somewhere next to your face where you feel it supporting you. And then on the next inhalation, you can lift up, pressing into the floor, come back to center. And walk your hands in and one knee at a time, or two knees at the same time, come in. Just sit on your heels for a moment and feel what it's done for you. Give your body a moment to find its balance back and to integrate the work. Feel the rebound as well. And from here we move into a side bend. So we come to a half butterfly pose. We're going to start with taking the left leg out when you sit and your right foot on the inside of the left thigh. And again, it's really helpful to sit up on something here. And if you feel this is not great then for the knee, you can always place something under the knee of the extended leg to support it. And some people experience a lot of strain behind their knee, or even when you sit up something, the knee is hanging down too much. So feel free to support it. So we're going to get into a side bend, and it's nice to be able to have your elbow on something or just your hand on the floor or even on a block. So you can use bolster, pillow, blocks, doesn't really matter. So first, just for a moment, sit upright. Yeah. Allow yourself to root down to the sit bones. Open the pelvic floor to the energy of the earth. And just for a moment, just open the right side by just drawing your right shoulder back a bit. Yeah. And then you feel a little turn. And then you inhale, take your right arm up. And exhale, now you bend over that left leg. And it doesn't have to be very far. For example, I'm quite tight on the right side, just above my hip. So I won't go very far to give my time, my body space to open. But I can rest my left forearm on a block, on a brick, just to support myself and be comfortable here. And Masha can go a little deeper. And you at home have to figure out what works for you. But don't push, because we stay for a while. Time pushes it for you. So again, 3 minutes. You can do different things with your top arm. You can see Masha having the elbow bend and the hand behind her head. I have my arms a little straight. And you can even, if you have shoulder issues, bring your arm to your side, turn the palm away, and then place your hand on the lower back and have it there. So it's really choices. Feel free to try something out and then stick with what feels good. And then come back to the breath. And remember, you don't have to go deep. It's not about that. It's about working with your body. Find the focus on the gentle sound of the breath back. And feel the breath moving into the side body. Can support your head with the bottom hand if you like, or when you can't reach it, just keep your head up by yourself, doesn't matter. Don't push yourself to get anywhere though. Be mindful, but also respectful to your body. And to its edges. And the breath should be relaxed. It's a relaxed effort. So I know it's ujjayi, it's the ocean sound, but there's still a very relaxed effort there. You can extend your right arm up to the ceiling, and then let that bring you back up. Wonderful. Extend your right leg. Just take a moment here to feel both sit bones grounding evenly. You pull your lower back in, your chest is open. And then you fold in your left knee. Your foot comes to the inside of the right leg and the right leg is out. And move whatever you've used around so you have the support on the other side. And this helps to obviously give space to the breath because we're opening the side body now. And then you can again, first of all, sit straight up and then just gently open the left shoulder a bit to the left. Feel that you're already turning towards the right leg with the right side. And then you can find your support. Inhale, take your left arm up and over. And find your pose and the variation that works for you. And come back to that sound of the breath. There's nowhere to go. There's just to work with what is there. Don't panic. If sensations are too strong, you just come out of it and you're more gentle with yourself. Soft, gentle sound. It's kind of an effortless effort. Aware of the in and the out breath, one breath at a time. And anything else, let it go. All you need to focus on is the breath. Every time you've drifted, just be aware and bring your attention back. Soft breaths. And with a gentle ujjayi sound. And your next inhalation, take your left arm all the way up and then reach long through the left arm and let that help you come back to sitting upright. And like to another time, extend your left leg out. And you just want to sit straight up. You may even place your hands behind you for support, to support the uprightness of your back and the openness of your chest. Even the shoulder blades firm in a bit to encourage the chest to open. You feel a little opening on the insides of your legs, the backs of the legs. Okay. And then you can bring your legs in, just help them in. And the last pose, we will lie back over a bolster. So you could even have your face this way, your head this way. Mm-hmm. And we can look at Masha first, how she sets up her pose. So we have a bolster or folded blankets at home or a couple of pillows to support the back so that your chest opens nicely. And you can see Masha is totally okay. You can extend the legs out to have nothing supporting her head. If I do the same pose, I'm not okay. In this way, I need extra height under my head for my neck to be comfortable because my back bend is not as deep. Yeah. So at home, basically, you want to feel a nice opening in your chest, your inner back bend, but you want your neck and head to be fully comfortable. So place folded blankets extra under the head. A nice way as well is to place this block underneath the top of that bolster. And I'll set myself up for that and you can see. And then we stay for another 3 minutes, starting now. So I have an extra block under the top of my bolster. I sit with my hips just about touching or just about not touching. I like a little bit away with my hips and then I lie back. I turn my palms up and I have my arms a little outstretched. Come back to that soft ocean sound. and make it really soft and effortless. One breath at a time. Keep focusing on that breath. At the same time, begin to notice how your body feels now as well. Begin to let go of the ujjayi breath, the ocean breath. Let go of the sound. Let go of the effortless effort. And come back to your natural breathing rhythm. Follow that for a moment. And then from here, come back to a meditation seat. So take your time to come off the roll. You could bend your knees and then bring your knees over to one side and roll off the bolster. Help yourself up. Maybe sit back on a meditation pillow or on a blanket to support your seat. And we'll sit for a few minutes just to observe. Another 3 minutes, actually. Natural breathing rhythm, no effort at all. Just let it happen. But still following the breath. But notice now the breath is much more subtle, so it's harder to be with it. But we've practiced, so now you can do it. Stay with it for another few seconds. Feel the subtleness of the in and the out breath, the movement in the body. And then for the last minute or so, let go of all focus. Just be with what arises in the field of your awareness, whether that's breath, whether that's a thought, whether that's sensation. Just let it happen. Maybe it's also nice to check in how you feel. Let that arise. No doing, just being. So during this half an hour, we've moved from doing to being, from thinking to feeling. And if anything, this settles deeply your whole body and mind. So you feel more relaxed and much more peaceful at the end of a practice like this. And of course, you can stay in meditation for as long as you wish. Yourself. We at Eckhart Yoga here are going to say goodbye to you. Thank you so much for joining us, myself and Masha, in this practice. I hope you enjoyed it. And leave us a comment how it was for you. Namaste.